Hi friends, welcome to the VARC with Harpreet Kaur Dhodi, and today's topic is PYQ 15, guys. We have already done 15 lessons on previous year's question papers. Bugs Bounty is an opportunity for learners to report any kind of inappropriate content in the video. My name is Harpreet Kaur Dhodi. I have a master's in English literature. I have a diploma in journalism. I have 17 years of teaching experience. I've trained students for exams like the CAT, MAT, SAT, SNAP, PGCET, Banking, GRE, GMAT, SAT, ACT, and TOEFL. Today I'm an educator on hashtag CAT Live Daily. Telegram channel is there, guys. Please go ahead and join my Telegram group, Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy CAT. Please join Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy CAT. And we have two kinds of subscriptions. We have the plus and we have the iconic also. If you take the plus, you have live classes, weekly tests, unlimited access, and structured courses. And if you want to take the iconic, guys, you have much more. You have personal guidance, study planner, study material expert guidelines, and test analysis too. Plus subscription is there for the benefit of students, guys. You have 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, and 24 months subscription. If you take the 12 month subscription, 3 months is free. 24 months also, 3 months is free, guys. You can use Core 10 in order to subscribe. You have Core 10, guys, to subscribe. You will get a 10% discount. And again, in the iconic also, guys, 6 months here, 12 months, 24 months. Please use Core 10 in order to subscribe. You will get a good discount. So please go ahead and subscribe today because there are many, many batches and many, many courses. If you want personal attention, please go ahead and take the iconic. A very good morning to all my students. Welcome to the hashtag like subscribe. Crack management exams, please subscribe. Enroll now, guys. There are many batches which started. There are two batches which started yesterday, and they are CAT 2022 batches. And we also have a practice batch for CAT 2021. So those who need to enroll for next year, please enroll. Those who need to enroll this year, please go ahead and enroll. So we are doing PYQs 15. Are you ready? Please give me a thumbs up and like the video, all those who are ready to take this lesson with me. I have been doing 17 questions every day, guys, from a different paper. This is from a 2017 paper, right? And 2017 number of questions was higher. So therefore, guys, 17 questions in yesterday's paper and 17 in today's paper also. So are you ready? Yes, Piyush. Thank you. Okay, now going into the first passage. Done, guys. So you know this particular story of Elon Musk, and that's what the author is talking about. It's a remarkable figure of a machine with fairly short range and very limited number of specialized charging stations. So these are the features of this particular vehicle, hybrid. Right, and then it's talking about the founder. This sentence is talking about the founder and how he managed. Right, now we are going to the next paragraph. Now, what is the last he's talking about here is he's selling a dream that the world wants to believe in. So, this idea continuing in the next paragraph, this last may be the most important factor in the story. So he's talking about the positives and negatives, right? So what is the story in the traffic? Comparison with fossil fuel cars. What are the benefits? They are as silent as bicycles, but they are dangerous because they are not making any audible warning. Can you read that? So always create a PowerPoint presentation in your mind about what is the central idea of each paragraph and save it in your mind so that when you go to the questions and you come back to the passage, you know where to look for answers. Okay, guys? Another benefit. Good morning, Pratik. Hi, Richa. So, look at this. What will happen then to the fantasies of independence? We will have to take to electric powered cycles, bicycles, right? So, have you finished? What is the author's argument here? Yes, I'm waiting for the answers, guys. You have to answer the questions. What is the author's argument? Which of the following reflects the author's argument? Do you want to read the passage once more? Because I can see many students just joining in. Yes, aaj Sunday hai, people are I'm sure relaxing. What is the author's argument, guys? Look at this particular sentence. I was showing you this sentence. Mr. Musk is selling a dream that the world wants to believe in. This sentence is very, very crucial to decide what is the author trying to say. Yes, so this is what he is talking about, unattainable fulfillment. Second sentence of the third paragraph is talking about unattainable fulfillment, but at the same time, theater for myths of unattainable unfulfillment, self-fulfillment, sorry. So the potential car buyer, he says, is never told about the traffic jams, is also what he's trying to say, right, somewhere here. So we have to pick up clues from the passage itself to mark the answers, guys. So answer therefore will be C. Private car represents an unattainable myth of independence. The myth of independence of the private car is perpetuated. So what is going to happen is that the traffic jams is going to rob him of his independence. So that is why we will mark C. Yes, we cannot look at something. Is he talking about it's the end of the age of internal combustion engines? Gifted salesman is not what the argument, his argument can be. Future Uber will environmentally friendly, then is not even the answer. Answer will be C, guys. Unattainable independence is what the author is trying to say, right? Okay, let's go to the second question. The author points out all of the following about electric cars except question. Every day, guys, you notice we are having to answer one question on main idea and one on except. So you have to understand what is the trend. When you do so many question papers, you will realize what is the trend and what are the kind of questions that appear in the examination. Year after year. What is the answer? Rahul, are you taking the exam this year or next year? Yes, ask this year or next year. Answer is D. It will ultimately undermine. So when the paragraph, in the fourth paragraph, what is the author trying to say, guys? Yahan pe, what he's trying to tell you? That it is going to make dynasties rich. So electric cars would of course pollute far less than fuel ones. Instead of oil reserves, the batteries would be undeserving despots of fantastically rich, right? So therefore, this one is definitely mentioned. Sorry, this one is mentioned, right? They will reduce air and pollution is mentioned. They will decrease the number of traffic jams is mentioned. But they are not saying undermine rather than further driver autonomy. This one is not mentioned. Yeah, he's saying that they will be more breathable, so therefore that is also validating B. Traffic jams will be abolished only where he's saying in para 3 is talking about decreasing the traffic jams, so D is the answer. Is that fine? Let us go to the third one. According to the author, the main reason for Tesla's remarkable sales is that. What is the main reason for Tesla's remarkable sales? Yes, Rahul, so you should take the plus, aap plus join kar lo. Bahut sare batches shuru ho rahe hain. You can join those batches and you can start learning. You can take a two-year subscription le lo. Plus subscription bhi hai, iconic bhi hai. Iconic mein personal attention hai. There is personal attention in the Iconic. Otherwise, you can take the Plus also, whichever suits your pocket. And if you use Core10, you will get a 10% discount. Use my code Core10 and join an academy. We will take care of all your concerns. Kahan se shuru karna hai, kya padhna hai, kya practice karna hai, kya study material hai. Everything, mock test, everything will be given to you. Okay? Yes, so you can download the Unacademy Learner app. And you can go to CAT courses and you can subscribe Rahul. Question number 3, answer is in D. What is the remarkable sales? What is the reason is D? Because people believe in autonomy represented. So he's talking about freedom, right? He's definitely talking about the aspect of freedom. He says sleek and swift. Autonomy and power. In the beginning of the fourth paragraph, if you notice, the sleek and swift electric car is at one level merely the most contemporary fantasy of autonomy and power. This is the sentence which is very, very vital to answering this question, guys. So therefore, the answer here is going to be people believe in autonomy represented by private cars. What will happen in the long run? The US government has announced tax subsidy. The companies, all these are irrelevant. Answer is D. Very good. All of you are giving me D as the correct answer. Sonali, Madhu, Sharma, all of you giving me correct answer, guys. Now, can we go to the fourth question? The author comes to the conclusion that. So, when you're talking about the conclusion, you have to definitely look at the last paragraph. Yes, let me like take you to the last paragraph. So he's saying this is where the fantasy of autonomy comes a full circle. This is an important sentence. The logical outcome of cars which need drivers, they will become cars which need no owners. And this is going to the future Uber is working on. Right? So that is why, what is the answer? What is the conclusion? So when you say it comes a full circle, you are trying to say it returns to the beginning and that there will be no autonomy. He goes on also to say through the balance of the part of the paragraph that public transport will be reinvented. So what will be the answer, guys? That is why the example of Uber. Yes, Shruti, you're right. Yes, car drivers dream of autonomy, but the future will be public transport. You cannot say car drivers will no longer own cars. That is a very close call. Yes, unseen passage aate hain. Very close between A and C. He doesn't say drivers will no longer own cars, guys. their dream of autonomy, but the future may be public transport. Cars will be controlled by technology that is more efficient than car drivers. Electrically powered bicycles are the way to achieve. No, this is not the answer, guys. So between A and C, when you are trying to come to a full circle, you start with wanting to get autonomy for a car, but you end up with public transport. And that's why the example of Uber, which he's giving you in the last paragraph. So he is trying to say that it will be reinvented. Public transport will be reinvented. And the future will be one of public transport. Okay, coming to the fifth one. In para 5 and 6, the author provides the example of Uber to argue that. Why is he giving you the example of Uber, guys? Yes, easy answer. Very easy database question. Can I take you to the last paragraph? This one. The dream goes further than that. These are the two last paragraphs that you have to read in order to find the answer to this question, number 6. So why is he saying the ultimate development of the private car will be to reinvent public transport, traffic jams will be abolished when the private car becomes a public utility, and what will then happen to fantasies of independence? We'll have to take electrically powered bicycles. So why is he giving example of Uber? Yes, very easy answer, guys. Question number 5, sorry, not 6. Yes, Ashutosh, correct. C is the answer. In the future, private car will be transformed into a form of public transport. This is what he is saying. Now, this is data-based easy question. It's mentioned in the last passage, paragraph. So, you should be able to find the answer to this, right, guys? Okay. Please like the video, guys, as you go on. In the paragraph 6, the author mentions electrically powered bicycles to argue that. Why is he mentioning electrically powered bicycles in the end, guys? It's very easy to eliminate options here. I notice that options that are given are very easy to eliminate and it's easy to arrive at an answer. So if we still want freedom and we want autonomy, the author is saying we have to switch to cycles, right? Yes, Prateek, correct. He is not mentioning electric buses, Madhu. Yes, Arzu, correct. Ashutosh, Richa. Yes, our fantasies of autonomy might unexpectedly require us. So if we still want autonomy and we are not getting it through cars and Uber is taking over and, you know, giving us electric cars which are driverless, then we will have autonomy which will require us to consider bicycles. That will give us autonomy. Autonomy means freedom. Autonomy and freedom being synonymous, right, guys? So answer therefore is B. So were you able to get all answers correct? Has the scores gone up? Is your accuracy going up, guys, as a result of these PYQ classes? Those who are regularly attending or watching the videos. Okay, MBA 2021 MAC mock test marathon. You can please go ahead and take the iconic 6 months, 4,300 per month. It is good. And you can subscribe now, pay 25,800 for 6 months. Please go ahead and enroll and please use code 10 to unlock. Please use my code in order to unlock. It will be of great benefit. 6 on 6, Prateek, very good. Definitely improved, Richa, very good. Those who have not watched the previous videos, please go and watch them so that your scores will also improve. A big surprise awaits you guys. Those who have not yet gone to the plus, take the Mega Combat. Take the Mega Combat. It's happening today at 12 p.m. today, guys. Mega Combat is there. It is free. Please go ahead and enroll. Please use Core 10 to unlock. So when you enroll for the Mega Combat, please use Core 10 in order to unlock. You will get a scholarship. 250 students getting a scholarship this time. So I'm sure you are smart enough to get above 200 itself, right? Yes, Richard, 3 on 3, very good. Plunder means to attack and to steal. Yes. Attack and steal. Pillage also means to destroy. Are you understanding the passage, guys? Antlers are like the horns of the reindeer. So from that only they make combs. Yeah. You know that, you know, you have antlers like this. Reindeer ke horns hote hain. So isme se combs banaya jata hai. Decorative combs. And they are trying to trace where did they come from. So, given that reindeer don't live in Denmark, they think that they came from Norway. Right, Richard, good. Okay. Very interesting passage. Yes, can I go to the questions, guys? What is the primary purpose? I told you every passage has primary purpose and except question. Either primary purpose. What do you mean by purpose? Purpose is why is the author writing this passage? So what can be the purposes, guys? The author can be doing an analysis. He can be doing an argument or a debate. He may be giving a narration of a story. He may be doing a description. It may be a strong opinion. Right, so these are different kinds of purposes why the author is writing the passage. So this is what we should know. What is he trying to do? So look at these words. These words are important. Is he trying to explain? Is he trying to contradict? Is he trying to challenge? Is he trying to argue? Yes, we'll leave out D, guys. There is some error here. Yes. Look at A, B, C, and E. What is he trying to do? Explain, contradict, challenge, or argue? Despite their fierce freedom, it goes to suggest that the Vikings were traders since the artifacts were found in marketplaces. Yeah, this should come here, and then D is actually missing. Now, what is the answer? What is the purpose? No, guys. Let me take you to the passage where he's saying this starts with despite their fierce reputation. You know, the Vikings, they were also always known as being plunderers and pillagers. Popular culture imagines them. In fact, they got their start trading in northern markets, researchers suggest. So what is the author trying to say? And then second paragraph is saying, since the artifacts were found in marketplaces, areas at each site, it's more likely that they came to trade rather than pillage. They are traders, not only pillagers. Right, guys? So now tell me, what is the answer? What is the answer? Correct, Shruti. It is C. To challenge the popular perception of Vikings as raiders by using evidence that suggests that the earlier relations with Europe. So they were involved in trading. And they were not only always, they were not the ones who were always attacking or pillaging. To explain the presence of, this is incorrect, contradict the widely accepted beginning date, no, argue that besides being violent pillagers, Vikings were also skilled craftsmen. No. They were not skilled craftsmen, but they were traders. Yes, contradict is fine, but not the beginning of the date of the Viking, right? Yes. Pillage means to attack and to burn. Yes, when you attack something and plunder and burn and to destroy, it's known as pillage, Aditya. Yeah, so they were known as plunderers. They used plunder and attack. Just like, you know, what used to happen in India during the rule of the Mughals. So the Mughals used to come into India. They used to attack, plunder. They used to take away all our resources, all our materials, gold, all the, what you call, gems and the jewelry. And they destroyed our temples and everything. So that is known as the Mughal emperors pillaged and plundered, right? Okay? Yeah. Coming to question number 8, the evidence, most of the artifacts also date to the 780s, but some are as old as 725, has been used in the passage to argue what? What is he arguing? Yes, you want me to go to this one? Yes, this one we have to read. Most of the artifacts also date to the 1780s, but some are as old as 1724. That predates the beginning of the Viking raids in Britain by about 70 years. Now tell me, what is the answer? Look at 8, eliminate options and give me the answers, guys. Correct, Arzu. Very good. So their trading relations with Europe predates the Viking raids. This is what he is trying to prove through this. The beginning of the Viking age should be changed. The Vikings started as early. Some of the antlers, no, this is not what the author is talking about, came from Scandinavia. It should be Scandinavia, right? Okay, coming to the 9th one, which of the following hold true for Vikings except? Again, except question. Every passage has a question based upon primary purpose, main idea, and except. So get used to answering except questions, guys, and getting them correct. They are easy because you have to find all the facts in the passage and decide which is the one which is not mentioned. Why not B? No, he's asking you, why is he using this evidence in the passage to argue what? Is he trying to argue that they were simply that they started as 725? So what do you infer from this data? Is what the author is asking you, not asking you to give the data. Aditya, you're not expected to give the data. You are supposed to derive from that data. So why is he giving the data in order to argue what? What is the point that the author is trying to make? That the Viking trade relations with Europe predates the Viking raid. So that should be the answer and not the data itself. Understand, Aditya, that we are doing a CAT examination. In school, we used to mark answers based upon what is data given in the passage. Here, you are required to infer from the data given in the passage. And the question is also asking you that. It's not asking you for details. It's asking you to infer and derive. Right? Okay, coming to this one, we accept question, guys. Question number 9. This is already mentioned, right? This is mentioned. Before becoming the raiders of Vikings had trade relations, this is what we did in the last question. Antler combs regarded by as a symbol of good health is also mentioned. Trade relations in Denmark and Scandinavia is also mentioned. All these are mentioned, right? What is the answer? A is the answer. This is not mentioned anyway that they brought the reindeer from Norway to Denmark. No, they believe that the reindeers may have come from Norway and not Denmark by way of trade relations. This one is mentioned, right? Vikings once upon a time had tried trade relations with Denmark and Scandinavia is mentioned. Here, beyond Norway, these combs would have been popular industry in Scandinavia as well. It is possible that the combs represent a trade network. Supplied raw material to craftsmen in Denver, Denmark and elsewhere. Where is A mentioned, Pratik? Where is he saying that they brought the reindeer from Norway? They brought the antlers is mentioned, Pratik. Yes, they bought the horns. But they did not bring the reindeer itself. You understand? Let me take you to the passage. First passage, first paragraph you are talking about. Sorry. So it says, given that reindeer don't live in Denmark, the researchers posit it arrived. What is it referring to there? It is referring to the combs from Norway. Yeah, molecular analysis all is talking about the antlers, right? Yeah, that it arrived in ships from Norway. So what arrived in ships is the combs, antlers, combs which were carved from reindeer antlers. Got it, right? It's very important to understand. Correct. Coming to the 10th one, guys. We are now doing question number 10, which is a summary question. What is the summary of the passage? Now, these are important questions. You have to learn to do these well. I will give you a minute. Please read it and give me the summary questions. We have three summary questions and then we have PJs. Very interesting paragraph, right? We did not even know this. So let us start eliminating options, guys. Let us start eliminating options. So the aspect of acoustics not mentioned in A. That's how you have to work the passage. Not mentioned. And he's saying they have specialized vocal tracts. Again, this one is incorrect. Right? Now, again, this is also not mentioning, it's just saying whistle loudly, but the aspect of deception is not mentioned, which is important. Yes, so therefore C is the correct answer. In a case of deception, camouflage. Now, this one is also incorrect because it is talking about deception and it is talking about deception and not acoustic deception. It's a case of deception, but it's not talking about acoustic deception, which is the more main thing here. Yes, Richa, I'm trying to tell you, North American walnut phoenix is a case of deception and camouflage, but it's not talking about acoustic deception. Do you see that difference now, Richa? And it's not even saying that the caterpillar camouflage. Camouflage means to cover up. Camouflage kaha mention kiya gaya hai? Is he talking about camouflage? Yes, there is no mention of camouflage, Ronak. Very good. I see that you people are able to analyze and differentiate. This is what you need to do. This is what you need to do. Right? If you are having clarity of thought, And you explain the passage to yourself the way I'm explaining it to you, and you try to understand what are the keywords that are used. You will be able to get summary questions correct, guys. Okay, next one is also a summary, 11th one. Look for words which are not mentioned in the passage to eliminate, like in the first one. Is he talking about clever questioning? He's not talking about clever questioning. So the first one is out. This is only a part answer. No, it's only a part answer, Madhu. They challenge arguments, theories by observation and experiment. This is a distortion and it is incorrect. Answer is D. They advocated examining arguments and theories from both sides to prove them. So both of them believe that arguments and theories can be validated by examining them from both sides. He says both of them have to be validated by examining them from both sides. So this is the best one. D is the best one because it is talking about both sides, challenging each other, collaborative affair. So this is the both sides that it is talking about. Right? So therefore answer is D. You got it? Okay, coming to question 12 is also a summary before we go to para jumbles, guys. Why not B? B is incomplete because it is only talking about observation and experimentation, but it's not talking about both sides, which the last part of the paragraph is talking about. Challenging each other is not mentioned, so it is a part answer. Arzu, this is incomplete. So I always tell students there is one way of eliminating options. If the paragraph is incomplete means it is a part answer, it is incorrect as in the case of C is incorrect, or if it is giving you details like examples which are irrelevant. So what is the author trying to say? This is a little difficult one, guys. The main point of the paragraph is the author is trying to say that language is fluid and its meaning is derived. Can you hear me? Okay, let me repeat. What is the author trying to say? The main point of the paragraph is that language is fluid and its meaning is derived from usage and exchange. Lexicographers abstract the meaning from that exchange, and this meaning is set within the meaning of the dictionary definition. So how it is used is what they are trying to derive the meaning, and then it is defined in the dictionary and made static. So what is the answer? Tell me, guys. Lexicographer is a person who writes dictionaries, coming from the word lexicon. Lexicon is also a dictionary. So lexicographer is a person who writes dictionaries. Yes, this was B can't be the answer, Shruti, because he's trying to say exasperate the problem. Language is already slippery. Given this, accounting for meaning in use will only exasperate. This will, why fix meanings? Is he saying we fix meanings because it exasperates the problem? No. Yes. Kushbu, Shweta, Saket. Answer is C. Meaning is dynamic, definitions are static. The meaning in use theory helps us understand the definitions are culled from meaning in exchange and not vice versa. Yes, guys. Now these two are trying to say the converse of what is, it is the converse of what the para is saying. Just the opposite of what the para is saying. Now this is a part answer. It is incomplete because it's not talking about that the definitions of words are extracted from their meaning in exchange. Meaning in exchange is not mentioned. Actual meaning of words in their free exchange. Artificial, theoretical, dogmatic, actual meaning of words in their free exchange is not talking about fixing the meaning. What is he trying to say? Abhishek, that's what I'm trying to explain. A. It is only a part of the paragraph and it does not mention that definitions of words are extracted from their meaning in exchange. Dogmatic means very inflexible. People who believe in dogmas. Dogma is a principle. And there are some people who believe in these principles and are very inflexible. They are not willing to change. If they believe in certain principles, they cannot change. That cannot bend. Right? Yes. This is B and D are saying the opposite of what the passage is saying. So therefore, the answer is C. Got it, guys? Okay. Coming to the next one, before we go to para jumbles, I would like to inform you, special class features are great. If you have been only attending YouTube classes, guys, please switch to special classes because they are very good. They are very interactive live classes. There are polls for learners. You can never miss a class. Lecture notes are given anytime, anywhere. You can take this class. I am taking a sectional test tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. Tomorrow morning, 11:30 a.m., there is a sectional test, guys. And we are doing, again, a mock test of sorts. It is a one-hour paper. Yes, happening on the 30th of August. So please join me there. Sectional test is the topic. And please use code CORE10 in order to join my special class. Please use CORE10 to join, guys. Okay, now we are going to the last three questions, four. Five questions. We have questions up to 17. We have to do a para jumble. Very interesting one, guys. Let me see you form this para jumble. Decide what is the opening sentence. Yes, Shruti, B is the opening. Start with B. The stories we tell reflect the world around us. Very good. B is followed by. No, B is followed by E. As soon as we capture a story, the world we are trying to capture has changed. So B is followed by E. Then we have C. We cannot help retell the stories that we value. After all, they are never quite right for us in our time. And even if. So this C and D are a link. CD is a link. Even if we manage to set them quite right. So he's talking about they are not never quite right. Even if we try to get them quite right. Yes. And lastly, you have A. The implications have, this is conclusive. Got it? So B, E, C, D, A. Correct. Yes. 14th one, again, para jumble. No. E is the opening because it is talking about the importance of lightning. One of the most dramatic examples in nature of ill wind that blows goodness is lightning. E is the opening. Very good. Yes, you're on the right track. Start with E. E is followed by. No, no, no. Go from general to specific, Pratik. General to specific. Correct, Abhishek. E and C is a link, right? Lightning starts the series of chemical reaction. So E and C is linked. Very good, Piyush. You're on the right track. E, C is followed by. Now talk about nitrogen. Because nitrogen is mentioned here. So C and D is linked. Then B is talking about the nature of the nitrogen. Before plants can take life from atmosphere, nitrogen undergoes transformation. Food undergoes in our digestive machinery. Yeah. E, C, D, B, A. B, A, Aditya. Not A, B. Yes, now you're getting it. So you start with goodness of lightning. What does lightning do? Nitrogen is mentioned here. Then you come to nitrogen, right? In its aerial form, nitrogen is insoluble. And what does it do? So very beautiful paragraph going from general. Lightning hai, then nitrogen hai, then what is the compound of nitrogen? And lastly, what does it do? Specific. So you see how the paragraph is forming. 60% of the paragraphs are general to specific. Okay. 15th one, guys, again, para jumble. Last three questions. So this cannot be the opening. This is not the opening. Effects are now studied. No, E is not the opening. Correct, Abhishek. Photosynthesis process. First, define the placebo effect. Define it. What is placebo effect? Definition dekho kahan hai. B. Piyush, correct, Shruti. The placebo effect is when an individual's medical condition or pain shows improvement based on fake intervention that as a real one used to regularly dismiss by research as psychological effect. B is the opening. Very good. B is followed by now he's talking about here real one, right? Yeah. So, this is talking about a contrast, right? Yeah, so it will be followed by E. E, guys. Placebos are not studied just as foils for real intervention, but as a potential portal in self-healing powers. So, they are not looked at as, you know, this is talking about a contrast, and this is saying it is no longer a contrast, but it is a valid way of healing the body. Look at this one, guys. So BE is followed by now tell me, BE is followed by foil means a contrast, guys. As a foil means it is just the contradiction. Yes, I am helping you to continue. No, Shweta. BE, don't jump. Look at the answer. Now see that the mind has the power to trigger biochemical changes because the individual believes a given drug will be effective could empower chronic patients. Self-healing powers being defined in D. So ED is a link. Yeah. How you can self-heal. Capacity for self-healing. Both self-healing are mentioned in E and in D. So E and D is a link because of the aspect of self-healing. Then C. Now it is solely not dependent on believing in treatment, but treatments are administered is also important. You can't discount the importance of the treatments is what he's trying to say in C. And lastly, A. Now you got it. B, E, D, C, A. If you're able to get till here, guys, CA will be easy to mark. Yeah. If you are able to get BED, then CA will be easy to mark. Okay, so at least get the first three sentences correct, then you will get the last also. Coming to question number 16, last two questions. Again, para jumble, and we have last two questions, 16 and 17, guys. What is the opening sentence? Go from general to specific. No, no, C is not. Don't get misled, guys. Go from general to specific. Which is the broadest sentence? Correct. 18th century English leader is the new world of global trade and warfare needed a dictionary with acts of definition for words ceded through the first British Empire by vigorous practical championship. Now follow it with C. Very good, Sharma. Samuel Johnson was a pioneer. Now name is given here in full, right? So you will not look at Johnson. This is only saying Johnson. This is only saying Johnson. This is saying Samuel Johnson. Right? So therefore C will follow. Was a pioneer. He was a beginner who raised the common sense heights of the genius. Now B, C is followed by... He's talking about his qualities. Correct. You're getting correct. I'm giving you time. E. Now look at this. The Johnson. The Johnson is a specific Johnson. When you say, I know Mr. Bose, but the Mr. Bose that I know lives round the corner. I know two Mr. Boses. The Mr. Bose that I know lives round the corner. So here Johnson is talking about his qualities. Right, describe his qualities. What were the qualities of Samuel Johnson being mentioned in E? Then you have A and B. Johnson treated English very practically. Don't even have to read the whole thing. Masking a profound inner torment found place in solace, peace in words of language. So how the paragraph is forming? D, C, E, A, B. You notice, guys? So please like the video if you like the explanation and if you are able to understand how to form paragraphs with me. You can always, before the examination, revisit all the PYQs that I did, guys, in order to arrive at correct answers. These are files which will always be live at any point of time. You can open one question paper and do the whole thing. Okay, identify odd one out. Try to do 10 questions or 17 questions at one shot. It will be a good practice for you guys. Odd one out pick karna hai 17 mein. Form the paragraph. Yes, very beautiful paragraph. If you have the right approach, you will find the answer very quickly, guys. You will find the answer very quickly if you use the right approach. No, Arzu. A is the opening sentence itself. Although we are born with a gift of language, researchers show that we are surprisingly unskilled. Negative sentence. Right. then go to E. We listen poorly without realizing it. I read only till here, till it is negative, right? Then you go to C. We often choose our words without thought, negative, oblivious of the emotional effects that we have on others. We talk more than we need to, again negative, ignoring the effect we are having on those listening to us. Which is the sentence which is positive? Which is the positive sentence, guys? A, E, C, D is the paragraph, Arzu. We have to pick odd man out. Odd one out karna hai. So, although we are born, we don't know. We are unskilled, he is saying. Correct. So, B is saying we must carefully orchestrate our speech. What we need to do. What to do. Because this one is saying what we need to do. These are all telling you the qualities of our speech, which are negative. You understand, Pratik? So first one is saying we are unskilled, we are poorly not realizing it. Then we are often choosing our words without thought. We talk more than necessary. All these are negative. And B is telling you what you want to do, and this is positive. It's a positive recommendation. You get it? This is how you have to pick the odd man out. So that was the last question for the morning. We did 17 questions and very, very exhaustively, guys. I have taken you through two passages and rest of the questions. We did about 6 questions. We did PJs. We did odd man out. And we did 3 summary questions also. So that was a great learning. E is talking about listening. No, it is talking about tone and cadence of our voice. We listen poorly without realizing it. We often fail to pay attention to the subtle meanings conveyed by facial body. And the tone and chance of our voice. So this is what is talking about the voice only, no? Speaking, speech. So how do you say this is talking about listening? Now you got it, Pratik? Cadence is the beat of the voice. 9 on 11, very good. Yes, those who have done 17 questions, what were your scores, guys? How did you do? I want to see an improvement from day to day. Every day there should be an improvement from past few days. We have already done 15 PYQ questions. 15 is a lot. Yes, so put up your scores, guys, right away. While I end, please go to Google Play or App Store, download the Unacademy Learning app, guys. Get your subscription. You can go to Plus Courses. You can click on CAT and get your subscription with Core 10. Use Core 10 to subscribe. You will get a discount. 12 on 17. Okay, guys. So subscribe, like, share. Hashtag CAT Live Daily. And this is my referral code. Those who have not yet subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe with Core 10. You will get a 10% discount. That is the end of today's session, guys. All the best. Bye-bye. Take care.